AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. This is the National Football League.
But as you can probably tell, the mouths of these Cowboy fans could not be more wide open. It is a frenzied AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction to the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football in Big D as their guys will do battle with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Started, and this one is underway here on EA Sports. Taken at the goal line, and he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. Always fun to get a peek at Tom Brady as he gets in place to command this offense for Tampa Bay.
Well, we've all seen what Tom Brady can do on a football field for a couple of decades now, but how about his most impressive accomplishment? Moving to a different franchise and taking them to a Super Bowl title as well. Not many players can continually stiff-arm Father Time the way that he has.
Brady now on first down. This one complete to Giovanni Bernard. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard. Now a first carry for Giovanni Bernard. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
An early test for this defense. Here we go on third and inches. A first carry for Leonard Fournette. And this is going to be a Bucs first down as the tackle made just shy of the 40. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
Gotta give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and give some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
Here's second and 10. Now Brady. It's complete. It's Miller. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackle behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
down, the Cowboys bringing an extra defensive back. Brady gonna throw. And this is caught by Evans. And he's gonna come up a few yards short. Brought down at the 45. They'll get 8, but they're gonna have to punt here on the opening drive because that's not enough.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on draft routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short gain.
So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. CeeDee Lamb deep for the Cowboys. This is taken at about the 14. A nice return that time, gets 12 yards back. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Now we'll see what the right arm of Dak Prescott has in store as the Dallas Cowboys offense sets up shop.
It's been a lot of fun watching him advance in his career. Many people question his ability to throw the football coming out of Mississippi State. He's conclusively answered that question. In addition, a very strong runner and an even better leader.
So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 26. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Run got 6, now second and 4. A give to Elliott. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. The tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the 4th overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watch tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs, because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact type of runs.
First down carry by Elliott. Shaquille Barrett in on the tackle.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description, because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. From the shotgun, it's Prescott.
Left side to Lamb.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 47. This is Lamb on the end around. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
But defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, and one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
Counting down toward the midway point in corner one. On second down, it's Elliott. It'll be a gain of five, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a third and three. The give is to Elliott. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Well, we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Too long for a field goal, too short to punt. That in-between range, and they'll go for it on fourth down. Running with Elliott, twisting away, and he won't get there. They stop him a few yards short of the line to gain. Ezekiel Elliott not able to get it past the marker. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. Tampa Bay, they're getting ready to set up shop here for their second drive. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a second and three, second and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Brady and the Buccaneers here, first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Brady's throw pulled in by Gronkowski.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Well, there it is, partner. Brady to Gronk, their first connection of the game.
You think those two often in sync?
I don't think there's any question about it. And look, we know Gronk has a whole lot of fun, but he's deadly serious about his football, as is Tom Brady. Two great competitors, two fantastic players.
On first and 10, here's Brady. And he's got Gronkowski yet again. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Here's Brady to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Bernard. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. to the 20 to keep the drive alive on third down. Now Brady. Gronkowski's got it on the crossing route. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. A handoff to Fournette. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep a defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Second and 7. To throw is Brady. Getting it out wide here to Bernard. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it can turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Throwing is Brady on third down. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. Tyler Johnson there to make the grab. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball in the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
Extra point up and good by Succa. And that makes the score 7-0. Now Pinion with a kickoff honors following the touchdown. This fielded right at the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 22. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. Wide open, Amari Cooper. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. So Amari Cooper out of Northwestern High School in Miami making a nice play there.
And it's so funny that when I was going through the draft process when he came out of Alabama and was inquiring about him and his skills, they say it all began back in Miami. He really became a pro receiver at a young age because of his attention to detail and precision. But don't forget his athletic ability. That's what made that catch there.
And he did spend 1 year with Teddy Bridgewater as his quarterback there, so that helped back in high school.
On first down, it's Elliott. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, my bad, we simply couldn't move him off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Throwing on second and eight. Prescott out to the right here to Wilson. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down. Executed it to perfection. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Here's Elliott. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Throwing. Prescott. Over the middle. Hauled in by Lamb. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 20-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
From the red zone now, Prescott. This is caught. And he's brought down after a very nice game.
He's certainly done a nice job spreading the field on this drive. And here he finds his big tight end for good yardage. And that's what you have to do. Keep defenses guessing about where you're going to go with the football.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Looking to throw. Prescott. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Cedric Wilson there to make the grab. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. And down near the goal line here, they're able to throw it in.
And the key word, quick. Quick hitter out of his hands fast, into the receiver's hands even faster.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it's capped off for the Cowboys touchdown. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Fielded just outside the goal line.
And he won't quite make it to the 25. A time to get another look at this Buccaneer offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Brady and the Bucs now with a first and 10 at their own 24. Throwing to start the drive. Brady. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Normally you think the tight end's gonna be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well, incomplete.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now Brady. He finds his target, it's Evans. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. They'll wind up losing three here on the play, and that'll make it third and 13.
They completed the screen on the perimeter, but boy, that was textbook defense, exactly as you're taught to play against a wide receiver screen, and they snuffed it out for a loss of yardage.
On third down, they've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is going to be third and 13. To throw, it's Brady. He drops it off for Bernard, and this will not get close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the 26. 5 yards, not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back, but how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. It'll be a 41-yard punt, given 5 on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now Dak Prescott and the offense heading back onto the field. 5 for 5 that last drive. Touchdown pass as well. He was clicking. Receivers, I don't want to be cliche, but running really solid routes too.
And what I love about it is when you look across any team, all right, the body types of the receivers are usually different. The way that they get open, different as well. Some of them use power to get open. Some of them use those head fakes and subtle moves. Some of them just use pure speed. And the really good ones, when they're established, they know how to push off at the end of a route, too.
Prescott's throw taken in by Jarwin. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
And that was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver. Although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
Prescott on first down. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. And he'll take this from 147-yard line to the other. A gain of 6. Four yards remain for second down. To throw is Prescott. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. The sack by the Super Bowl champion and Pro Bowler, Jason Pierre-Paul.
I thought there at the end he may have had a chance to release that, but that pocket closed a little too quickly, and down he went.
Yeah, he was certainly trying to do everything he could to extend the life of the play, probably counting in his head, 1, 2, and then he ran out of time.
And
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Here's Prescott.
He'll get this out wide here to Elliott.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 5 yards, not enough, and it'll be fourth down. To kick this one away. And this punt sails over the sideline, and the spot, it looks to be right at the 25-yard line.
Back now comes Tampa Bay.
The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a first and 10
at their 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Brady looking middle, and it's incomplete.
Well, we've seen him catch a few passes out of the backfield in the first half, unable to connect on that one.
Certainly seems like getting him the ball out of the passing game, though, is part of their game plan.
It certainly is, because he catches it well, creates a mismatch. You're going to cover him with a linebacker, a corner, a safety. They feel like he can win every battle.
On second and 10, Brady.
He's going to drop this one down to Bernard.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
On first down, Brady. Goes right side, complete to Gronk. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
When Mike Evans sees man coverage, I don't think he's the only guy who gets excited. I'll guarantee the guy throwing the ball does, because guess what? He's got a lot of options about where to place it because of Mike Evans' size and frame.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 47. Again, it's Brady. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
Well, I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over it, and they got there to break that one up.
Second and 10.
Brady. This is Miller, complete. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Throwing now is Brady.
He'll drop this off for Bernard.
And he's not even able to get back to the line of scrimmage. Now there's also a flag down, and it's in the area of holding.
That's on the guard, Alex Kappa.
Thank you.
up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. After the penalty, it's Fournette. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. Moving backwards on first down, never a good thing. What does that do for the mindset on second down?
Well, it changes your play call, definitely, because as a play call, you're advancing yourself, thinking, okay, we're going to get a gain here. Now you've got to go back in reverse, come up with something to pick up not just the yardage lost, but gain a few extra.
Throwing on second and long. Brady, it's caught, it's Miller. A nice pick up there, 19 yards. And they're set up better for third. Try and run for it with Fournette. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went three and out.
Throwing on first down is Brady. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Now Brady gets away with one. Lucky, could have been intercepted, but it falls to the ground. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range, so now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
From the gun on third down, Brady. Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. Osa Odighizawa able to get him down for a loss of 11, and it brings up fourth down. So Brady departs, and on it's Ryan Succop for the Buccaneer field goal. From the left hash, it's an even 50-yard attempt. Succop's kick is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So as it turns out, that sack doesn't wind up costing them, Charles. They at least get points, get three of them.
Yeah, that's where your kicker can really come to your rescue because you know, after the sack, there was a little consternation there. Are we out of field goal range? Are we going to be able to get three? In this case, he stepped right up and gave them exactly what they needed.
The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. This is Tony Pollard. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Deck
Prescott on the offense heading back onto the field. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but they're losing. And I think as the captain of the offense, you probably always feel like you need to do more in that situation.
The best have always felt that way, and they won't settle for anything less. So right now, his goal is to increase what he's doing on the field, try to make sure his teammates come along with him, and he feels like if I do better, everyone will do better. And that's what we're seeing from him right now. Got to have a little extra determination.
Yeah, the little extra determination. He has thrown the touchdown pass. No interceptions for him personally to this point. And he finds his target. It's Schultz. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10. Remaining in the first half, 10-7, our score. We remind you in just a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Orlando and our good friend Jonathan Coachman. Coach will run through some of the numbers and the next-gen stats from this first half of football so far. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Here's Prescott. He finds his man complete. That's Schultz. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Normally on third down and short yardage, you're thinking to throw to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field, and a nice dart picks up the first down and then some.
First down now, but the clock continues to move. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. A dump off to Elliott, and they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. And again, it's Prescott. Over the middle, Amari Cooper, it's complete. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. First down, Prescott. He's going to go up top for the end zone.
And it is incomplete. Good positioning there downfield to break that one up.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now Prescott. That one complete to Elliott. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. They'll throw again. Prescott. Open man, Lamb. It's complete. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver trying to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
So it's first and goal, and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. Now Prescott. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Very fortunate to get another shot. Here's second and goal. Prescott now. That is caught. It's Cooper for the Cowboy touchdown. Two first half touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys have retaken the lead. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
Zerline now for the PAT. And that makes it 14-10. A 10-play drive that time. And it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. So not much time to work with here. 9 seconds remain in the half as this one is away. Takes it at the 7. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And only 6 seconds on the clock, so time likely for just one play. Airing this one out for Evans. And this one is incomplete. So we've reached halftime here in a 4-point game. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one has been a hard-hitting affair to this point, and you gotta expect we'll see more of the same in the second half. And to bring the action your way, right back out to Brandon Godd.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. Now Pollard. And he returns this to the 22. The Cowboy offense set to go to begin this third quarter. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Second half starts with a carry by Elliott. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 43 yards
yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Hasn't had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Elliott. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard at 36.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
On second and 9, Prescott. Throw left side complete. That's Elliott. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him. I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. They'll run with Elliott. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job, and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
On second down, Elliott once more. And this time not as successful, as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Officially, it's no gain on the play, and they'll remain a few inches shy of a first with third down looming. Could be four down territory even if they don't get this, but they need just a few inches here on third. Prescott. It's caught. Cooper. And he will have a Cowboys first down, maybe by about a yard, as they find a way to convert on third and inches. Gotta say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage, so they're gonna throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
And he's taken down inside the 30.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. Scott looks to throw on first. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Lamb. And they'll get this down to the 10.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10.
And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call them, run fits, everyone was in the right place.
The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. Prescott to throw it. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be 3rd and less than a yard.
With all the success they've had throwing the football as a pass rusher, you know you've got to come hard when you see him drop back to throw. So I really like this call to counteract that pass rush with a screen. It turns into positive yardage. A lot of times the offense says, just replace the rusher with the ball, and it turns into a good play.
3rd and short yardage, Prescott. And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. 3 touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys take the opening kickoff of the 3rd quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Circle that drive, because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and that makes it a 21-10 game. Touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. Here comes the Buccaneers offense. They get their first reps of the 2nd half. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go 3 and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
Brady and the Buccaneers here, 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now he'll begin with a give to Fournette to start the drive. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
On 2nd and 9, Brady, he's got it complete to Gronkowski. 5th catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. Used to be occasional, right, safety valve, throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
Play action, now it's Brady. He's got the hookup to Miller. And he'll be stopped right at midfield.
A couple of first downs right in succession, and this is an offense that could really use a good drive, and they're off to a fast start here.
From midfield, here's Brady.
to Evans on the slant.
And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
In need of only about the length of the football here on second down. Shotgun now for Brady. Over the middle, complete. It's Johnson. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Hey, baby, this ain't good enough for us.
Instead of the first, they'll have to go backwards for another second down try.
So if there is a silver lining, though, it stays second down, and they still have an opportunity to pick up a first down before they have to start their downs over again.
Brady to throw again. Got a man complete to Miller. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Scotty Miller, 39 yards. And the Bucs have made this a one-score game.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. Brady will look to throw for it. And he's got it. So the try for two successful. And with it, they're back within a field goal. I guess the coach looked at the two-point cheat sheet, said go for it, get it to a three-point game, and they did it.
Yeah, and sometimes you just throw out time of game. You don't worry about that. There's just a feel sometimes in making that call, and he felt good about what he had for a two-point conversion, and now they're only down three and feeling great about themselves.
Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This one will come out to the 25 as Pollard is going to elect not to return it. Dak and the Cowboys ready for their next possession. And the numbers for the last drive, and he was perfect, which maybe isn't surprising because he has not missed a pass in this game yet.
And it lets you know just how precise things have to be for a quarterback to be perfect, because that means the line's blocking really well, no one's dropping any of the passes thrown to them, and the quarterback is accurate. It's almost like a pitcher throwing a no-hitter or a perfect game, isn't it? He's the principal guy, but he needs a lot of help.
Time to find out if he can keep that perfect game going here, partner. A first down throw for Prescott. And Wilson with it, complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
As they began this drive, I was wondering how they were going to attack since they're playing with the lead. Would they continue to try and push the ball downfield? Well, after one play, it appears that the answer is yes.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. And he's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Thank you.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Throwing. Prescott. Caught by Wilson. And he's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him, double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. They'll run on first down. Elliott. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. They go to Elliott again. And he won't get much. Maybe a couple down inside the 35 to the 34.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
The coverage unit out there thinking pass on third and three. Looking to throw, Prescott. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
So now Dak Prescott off, Greg Zuerlein on for the field goal. On the right hash, officially this will be a 51-yard attempt. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. Listen, now, no kick from 50-plus is a gimme, but here you're indoors in a dome. You'd think ideal conditions.
Yeah, and it's one that he would expect himself to make, not just us expecting him to make it. My theory is very simple. The athletic ability of kickers continues to get better and better. Check their backgrounds. They were all county, all state, and other positions, not just soccer players. These guys expect themselves to be great as well.
That throw by Brady, incomplete.
And I can see the officials kind of looking at each other down there, silently wondering, does this meet the level of grounding? Fortunately, he did have a receiver in the area, but I have seen less obvious throwaways called as penalties.
A good action to this point in the third quarter, just a three-point game, second and 10. Working from the gun, it's Brady. It's complete, he's got Gronk. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Fakes the give to Fournette. Now Brady. That's to Evans, and what a nice catch that is. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds.
That is one heck of a catch right there. Got his eye on it the whole way and able to make the grab one-handed. Very nicely done and for a nice chunk of yardage, too.
First down, Bernard shows the agility, and he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. We have played three quarters. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Into the red zone, it's Brady. And it's caught. And he's brought down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Fournette, touchdown, Buccaneers. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up. Meaning, when you get on a guy, you just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Suck up for the extra point. And that will make this a four-point game. So the drive there took six plays. And the man who finished it off with a run into the end zone, Leonard Fournette. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Dallas offense set for this next drive. But the bad news for them, they've seen that cushion they once had totally evaporate, and they're working from behind. The good news, they now have the opportunity to regain the lead right back. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He's got his receiver, Cooper. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Prescott from the gun. Wide open, Amari Cooper. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10, down at the 33. To throw is Prescott. Steps away to his left. It's a loss of four on the first down play.
So still 14 yards to go, second down. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Looking sideline, incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
The Cowboys on third down. Six conversions and nine tries. They've done a great job of picking these up. This is third and 14. Here's Prescott. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. Touchdown, Cowboys! CeeDee Lamb, 37 yards. And the Cowboys have once again taken the lead. But plenty of scoring here of late, and our lead changes hands now in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they just gave up a touchdown the other end, so they knew that with time getting short, they had to put something together here, and they were able to do so and retake the lead right back.
Now an important extra point here to stretch this lead to a field goal. He's got it, and this is indeed up to a three-point lead. Five plays there on that drive, and it's capped off for the Cowboys' touchdown. Touchdown at Zerline. He'll kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. Now the Buccaneers offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. A few better down a score in the fourth quarter than Tom Brady. This is first and 10. Now Brady. He'll check this one off to Fournette. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game? That's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. And in this case, he picks up a first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now Brady. This is caught by Evans. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now Brady. There's Evans again, complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
I love the drive they're working on here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They've moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively, but they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
Now Brady again. Throwing left side, it's complete. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Here's Brady to throw. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Tyler Johnson, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bucs have taken the lead here in the fourth.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
Extra point try now for Suckup. And that will make this a four-point game. That time, 75-yard drive, five plays. And it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Out comes CeeDee Lamb and the rest of the Dallas offense. Let's see here, Charles. Six catches, over 100 yards. Call that a pretty good day at the office.
And I love the accumulation, the catches, the yardage. That means he's having a pretty good impact on this ball game and really helping his team out in a big way.
Means he wants the football again, right?
And it's funny because some of these receivers are very vocal about how much they're getting it. Others are quieter, but they still let you know, give me the ball, I'm going to make a play.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. Shreds him with a stiff arm. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 93 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive. Out of the gun, here's Prescott.
He'll find Lamb, that's complete.
3 yards the gain there, second down. They like going to him in the slot, he catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
From the 41, Prescott, and he'll go right back to Lamb. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 37.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 37-yard line. Here's Prescott. That is caught by Lamb. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, Prescott to the left side and complete for Amari Cooper. And the Cowboys are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Now Elliott. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter.
So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
Extra point here to stretch this lead to a field goal. He's got it, and this is indeed up to a 3-point lead. A drive that time of 6 plays, and it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. Touchdown at Zerline. He'll kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble and bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
A few better down a score in the fourth quarter than Tom Brady. This is first and 10. Throwing now is Brady. He completes it to Evans. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45.
It's a gain of 17 yards. And the Buccaneers.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Here's Brady.
That's complete to his running back, Evans.
And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Brady. Oh, leaping, and he makes the grab. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. This offense can certainly move quickly when they want to. 3 plays, 3 pass completions. In the blink of an eye, they've got a first and goal.
Almost felt like a lightning bolt hit in this game, didn't it, for them to get downfield that quickly? And now first and goal, expect them to attack right here on this play.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. 5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal.
And, Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
On second and goal, Brady.
And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. The fourth touchdown pass of the game for Tom Brady. And the Bucs have taken the lead here in the fourth. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
Suck up for the extra point. And that will make this a four-point game. The drive summary that time, five plays. And it's all finished off with a touchdown by Tampa Bay. Now Pinion with a kickoff honors following the touchdown. Pollard to return from the end zone. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. Amari Cooper and the Cowboys set to take over once again.
And I know that they double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive.
And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
From the 31, Prescott looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Schultz. That catch good for five. It's third down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he was unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is third and three. They'll try and pick it up by running the option to the right.
Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. He'll get a couple of yards on the keeper, but it's going to lead to a fourth down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
One score down, here we go. They're gonna go for it here on fourth down. They'll run it with Elliott. And he's not gonna get there. Might have even lost a yard. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one score game.
So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Fournette, a first down carry. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. So they come up on second down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. Here's a give to Fournette. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. And they will take a knee here. Back at the 5-yard line now, second and goal. Now Leonard Fournette, and he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation. And taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Brady will take a knee here, and that should just about do it.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world, and get it done, how happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something. And they did in this one. So time has run out on what will be a Tampa Bay victory. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better. And that got it done in this one.
Partner Charles Davis and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. So long, everybody.